Hello, welcome to the second episode of our three-part series on how to set up a Bengali kitchen. In part one, we spoke about the items in the pantry that have a long shelf life, such as spices, grains or sauces, which typically can be restocked maybe once a month or so. If you haven't seen that video, go watch it after you watch this one. Last week's video was long. Today's in comparison is going to be short and uncomplicated. We'll be talking about some other pantry essentials which are equally important in running a kitchen, but as they go bad more quickly, they need to be bought more frequently, say once a week or so. So no matter what are the vegetable, fish or meat you're planning to buy that week, these are the things that you should never run out of in your kitchen.
First up, potatoes, onions, ginger and garlic. Bengalis have a spiritual connection with potatoes, which is why we add potatoes in vegetables, fish, meat dishes and even our biryani. In fact, it is so common that it is often not mentioned in the name of the dish. Mochar ghanto, for example, has potatoes, but no one calls it alu mochar ghanto. Plus, potatoes are great emergency food. Just knowing that you can throw in some potatoes to your rice while it's boiling and look forward to a simple hot meal of steamed rice, ghee, alu sheddho, and perhaps a fried egg can make all the difference when you are exhausted after a day's work. Same goes for onions, which though not as pervasively used in most of West Bengal as potatoes, are still important. You will need onions on an ongoing basis, not only for egg, chicken or meat curries, but also for an omelette or just as kacha piyaj with roti and murgir jhol. Next up, ginger. Many Bengali recipes use fresh ginger paste. This can be a pain to do every day. In fact, it is very difficult to grind small quantities of ginger in a grinder. So we have a tip for you. When you buy fresh ginger, set aside a small portion for recipes that call for finely chopped or julienne ginger or for tea. Then grind the rest of the ginger with a little water if required until smooth. Now portion the paste into an ice tray and freeze it for up to 2 weeks. We find this very convenient, not only because the ice tray pre-portions the ginger in small usable quantities, about 25 to 30 grams, but it also makes thawing it easier. Just take out a cube and melt it in the microwave for 30 seconds with a teaspoon of water. And voila, homemade ginger paste is ready to use. Garlic, again like onions, is not used as much in vegetable dishes in West Bengal. But you need it around, especially when preparing chicken or meat. Garlic paste loses its flavor when stored and stinks up the fridge. So it is best to grind it fresh. We find it easiest to do this in a mortar and pestle since garlic is not as fibrous as ginger.
Next, green chilies. In many of the Bengali dishes, heat is built up in several layers. It may come from ginger, black pepper or dried red chilies, both whole and powdered. But none of these can quite replicate the flavor that jhal green chilies can bring to a dish. Green chilies are used to temper the oil or add it to the dish, chopped, crushed or slit. Pro tip, if you remove the stalks of the green chilies and store them without the stalks, they will last much longer. A tiny bit of chopped coriander leaves or dhone pata added to some vegetable, fish or meat dishes serves to brighten them up. We sometimes also use dhone pata to freshen up leftovers like chicken curry or a plain dal. Curry leaves are optional, but we always pick them up if we see them in the market. Honestly, when we do have them at home, we find ourselves reaching for them for so many different dishes. They are great when added to evening snacks like pakoras or to dals.
A few limes or pati lebu are always good to have in your fridge. And if you're Bengali, chances are at least one member of your family habitually drinks lime squeezed in hot water each morning. Besides ritualistic cleansing, lime juice can be useful for marinades, chaat, lebu cha, lebu sharbat, and even to make chana. And a wedge of lime with hot rice and dal is always a treat. Tomato is another kitchen essential that you do not technically need for any specific recipe, but you may need it here and there in your cooking over the week. Like lime and tomato, yogurt, that is tok dui, is another ingredient in Bengali cooking that is used to add sourness. Besides cooking, yogurt is great for making a quick refreshing ghol in summer or a simple breakfast like doi chire.
Several Bengali dishes use chopped or grated coconut for flavor. Once we break open a coconut, we grate half of it and slice the other half into thin slices. In the freezer, these last a couple of months at least. Grated coconut can be defrosted in the microwave before using. Frozen coconut slices can be chopped into small pieces and added directly to the oil for frying. And we don't need to elaborate on the benefits of milk. It is great for drinking by itself as well as for adding to your tea or coffee. This is now fast becoming a list of emergency supplies, and perhaps that's what it is. So eggs obviously must feature on it. You may need them for breakfast or for evening snacks like dim paroti, and even in dimed kosha or dimed jhol. What we are basically trying to say is that we've never been sorry to have eggs in the house. Talking of dim paroti, you might consider keeping paroti or bread. It is such an easy thing to make into a snack when suddenly hungry.
That's our list for now. We've intentionally kept this one short and included only the very basic common things that most households need. You can go into specifics based particularly on your needs. Next week, come back for the last and final part of this series. It is on a topic that many of you have requested from us, so you won't want to miss that.